Prior to the First World War, the British Army were conducting a number of experiments to determine the most effective means of defeating a large network of barbed wire. Generally, engineers would be equipped with a set of shears to cut through the wire, but this was an incredibly slow process and endangered the life of the soldier. Some believed explosives could be the answer. In 1912, Captain McClintock of the British Army of Bengal in India imagined a metal cylindrical tube several meters long that could fit into other tubes in order to increase the area of the explosion. Filled with explosives, these cylinders are introduced through the network of barbed wire. After the explosion, the metal casings break down into multiple fragments that destroy the wires and open up a hole about 3 meters wide. The US military reused this process in the early 1940s and produced a large-scale torpedo, M1A1, known as the Bangalore, from the name of the city where the tube was designed. This torpedo consisted of several cylinders, each with the ability to connect to each other. They were roughly 1.5 meters in length and 5 centimeters in diameter, each of them containing nearly 4 kilograms of TNT. Up to 10 of these could be connected together, making a distance of nearly 15 meters. They were detonated by a fuse being placed in the rear of the last cylinder. Once activated, the soldier would seek shelter from the large explosion that would ensue. After the explosion, the hole in the barbed wire would open up, allowing the soldiers to move through the area. It was also determined to be effective in clearing other obstacles such as minefields. The Bangalore saw extensive use during World War II, but most notably on the beaches of Normandy during D-Day. The extensive barbed wire obstacles used by the Germans when building the Atlantic Wall was no match for the Bangalores. This was immortalized in the movie Saving Private Ryan, which showed how effective they could be. The use of Bangalores in the US Army continued following World War II. They are even still used today in various modified versions, but still follow the same basic principle. As always, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to leave a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button for more content.